Dalton Red Wolves and your Asheville City Soccer Club.
One more and more people, just one more and more freedom and love. What he's looking for, one more and more people, just one more and more freedom and love. What he's looking for, free from desire, mind and senses purified, free from desire.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure at this time to introduce the starting lineups for both teams. First of all, for the Red Wolves of Dalton, number 9, Ian Windham. Number 10, Joshua Ramos. Number 13, Mason Dalton. Number 30, former Asheville City player Jack Steenrod. Number 35, Rasmus Anderson. Number 38, Frank Rodriguez. Number 66, Michael Barretta. Number 80, Gavin Taylor. Number 87, Vincent Montoya. Number 88, Guillermo Franca. And number 99, Zachary Perry. Ladies and gentlemen, your Dalton Red Wolves. Now, the starting 11 for your Asheville City Soccer Club. A defender wearing number 2 from Northern Illinois, Malcolm Ward. A midfielder from the University of Kentucky, number 3, Max Miller. A midfielder from Elon University, number 8, Scott Vatna. A forward from University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill, number 10, Kinsey Herman. A defender from James Madison University, number 13, Josiah Blanton. From East Tennessee State University, midfielder, number 18, Kieran Richards. A forward, number 19, from Colorado State at Pueblo, Giancarlo Prieto. Also from Colorado State at Pueblo. A midfielder, number 25, Chao Oliveira. A midfielder from Florida International, wearing number 31, Matthias Levinan. Defender, number 35, from Jacksonville University, Abdul Manaf. And in goal, from Asheville, North Carolina, and Princeton University, number 24, Will Watson. Ladies and gentlemen, your first 11 for Asheville City. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if you'd please rise and face the American flag for the presentation of our national anthem.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, officials.
Beautiful
for
day
the
for soccer. We're coming to you live from Asheville, North Carolina.
Assistant referee.
Today's matchup, Asheville City Soccer Club taking on Dalton Red Wolves Soccer Club. Asheville coming in top of the table, first place with 16 points, 5-0-1 on the season for the Red Wolves. It's all or nothing. 3 wins, 4 losses, no ties. Their 9 points has them firmly in fifth place. One thing that struck me about this Red Wolves team, all games have been 1-0. This is a very organized, very together team. They win and lose by fine margins. Their current form, win, loss, loss, their last 5. Their last game, a 6-0 win against North Alabama. For Asheville City, 5 wins, no losses, 1 tie. The sole tie against East Atlanta, a 1-1 draw. 2 wins, sandwiching a tie. It's win, win, tie, win, win. Their last result, a Tuesday night home win, 3-0 against second place, the SC United Bantams. Asheville City running a 3-4-3 tonight. They've only let in 1 goal from the run of play. That's not an own goal. The rest have been penalties. And the 3-0 SC United score and an own goal that was part of the tie against East Atlanta. Dalton, 3 attackers. It's going to be Ian Windham, Mason Dalton, and Jack Stainrod up top. Wingbacks, Joshua Ramos and Rasmus Anderson. Frank Rodriguez wearing 38, Gavin Taylor, 80, 87. Vincent Montoya, Guillermo Franca wearing 88, 99 for Zachary Perry. It's a team with 3 changes over their 6-0 win against North Alabama. Perry Prieto and Ramirez Benritis falling to the bench in places Taylor, Perry, and Ian Windham. For Asheville City, 5 changes from the 3-0 win against SC United. Will Watson finds himself in goal wearing 24. Ward, Miller, Vatna, and Herman, the Chapel Hill product, continuing on, along with Levenant, the midfielder, and Abdul Manaf from Jacksonville. New players, Josiah Blanton, Kieran Richards, Giancarlo Prento, and Kyle Oliveira, taking the place of Zeller, Rashid, Vignali, Anderson, and Horvano. 3 at the back for Asheville City. The should look like a 3-4-3. There's Abdul Manaf across the back line. Ward on the far side. Good pressure from Stainrod. A foul spotted. I don't think rightly so. It'll be a free kick for the Red Wolves. Kenzie Herrmann able to scoop up the loose ball, but the foul on the header. Probably rightly spotted. Here come the Red Wolves across the back line. Looks like it'll be a very spread 2 or 3 at the back. Maybe a 3-4-3. Trying to move between the lines. Manaf heading it down. Miller. Oliveria trying to move forward. Gets clipped from behind. It'll be free kick for Asheville City as Windham spotted on the foul. Levenant pushes it wide. Trying to find the run of Richards. Richards, nice turn, has space in front. The crossing ball, flipped on, just can't find its way through to Miller. Miller settles it down. Asheville City now arriving into the box. Nice strength shown. And drawing the foul by Rasmus Anderson on the back line. It'll be a free kick for the Red Wolves. Max Miller taking on Anderson one-on-one. Anderson using his strength to get that positioning and then accepting the contact. Also, potential for a good chance. It'll be Barletta with the distribution. Barletta, fantastic season last season. And the Dalton State goalkeeper, a .5 goals against average. All the way back for Watson. Clipped away, and it'll play all the way back for Barletta. Barletta trying to play through the lines, nodded forward. Stainrod gives chase and wins the foot race there. It'll be out for a, it's either a deep throw or a corner, we'll see. The way they're lining up, I'm going to guess throw. And it will be. Flipped towards the box, knocked around. As Richards trying to carry it forward, the East Tennessee State product. Foul spotted in the buildup. Asheville City gets the free kick. Didn't look like a whole lot was on the counter, but maybe a advantageous foul for the Blues. Two of the better defensive teams in the league going at it tonight. This is a Dalton team that is so well organized. Good one touch. 3-on-3. Asheville still able to, Azel Oliveira probably using it wide for Miller. Miller looking up for options. Harriman makes the run. Miller cuts it inside. Miller one touch and just slices across the face of it. It'll be out for a Dalton throw far sideline. It's a ball that he wants to curl his foot around the outside and bend it into a run or maybe into that top corner. Just sliced underneath it. 5 minutes gone. Dalton two wins in their last three. Manaf looking for options. Back for Miller. Miller cycles through the center as Laminant. Laminant had trouble getting it under his feet, finally did. Here's Harriman. Miscommunication. Now here comes Dalton. Dalton looking to keep their width. They'll be doing it through Rasmus Anderson on the near side, really trying to stretch Manaf in that three-man back line. You'll see Miller coming over to help on Anderson. Good change of location attack, just narrowly too advanced for the Red Wolves. It'll be an Asheville City throw taken quickly. Dalton on the ball. Cross the back line. Dalton playing across the line. Pushed out wide for Anderson. Good bit of interplay by Asheville City. Now Ward is going to have some space in front. It's Windham trying to cut him off. Does so well. Blanton far sideline. Long run. as Miller tries to keep it in and unable to do so. Anderson over to throw in for Dalton near sideline. That goes Guillermo Franca, the captain of this Red Wolves team. Franca, Dalton State, and second team all-conference in the spring of 2021. All-academic for 2021 as well. 18 starts in 2022. Asheville City's press. So far, Dalton's been able to beat it. Dalton moving to the far sideline. Cuts it back interior. Looped back for Barroetta. On the ground. Here's Perry. Perry makes a move, has it tackled away. Here comes Asheville City looking to bounce quickly on the counter. Good scramble as doing just enough. Headed back into trouble. Oliveria barged into from behind. Foul spotted. Asheville City's two chances have really come on the counter where they've surged numbers forward quickly. That time it was Vatna. Kieran Richards, who couldn't get the ball out from underneath his feet in a good passing position as Dalton just kept sending runner after runner to thwart his ideas. Abdul Manaf into the fray. Ball on the ground. Flipped on. Dangerous, clipped over. Still alive, and it'll be scooped by Barroetta. A nifty training ground play. Nearly comes to fruition. It'll be Dalton to try to start out of the back. Here's the Asheville City press. Bad pass, scooped up by Miller. Miller, and they're gonna call a goal kick. It'll be a goal kick for the Red Wolves. The official determining the contact on Miller wasn't enough to give a foul in that position. That played off of Dalton. It'll be an Asheville City throw. Josiah Blanton rising on the far sideline to win the header. Dalton charging forward. Oliveria shrugged off on his challenge. Asheville City gets a leg in, wins the challenge. Here's Levenant. Trying to turn it up towards Vatna. Anderson plays it back across the back line for Franca. Franca is the Red Wolves retaking their shape. Diagonal ball. Watson well out of the box. Hits the ground, doesn't come up with it, and it's blasted well out. It'll be a throw on the far sideline. Boy, Watson got himself into a bit of trouble, but his back line able to stand tall. Dalton moving back to go forward. Perry settling, lays it off, gets it back. The pass loose, my goodness. A bit reckless on the slide challenge. No foul spotted. Cool. Dalton building from the back. Here's Barroetta. Franca. Ball trying to find a way between the lines. It's a foot race, and it's one Asheville City will win. Good speed shown by Giancarlo Preto. Anderson has it blocked out. It'll be a throw for the Red Wolves near sideline. All the way back for Barroetta. Here's Franca. Tries to play between the lines, clipped up. Manaf looping one to the other sideline. Oh, nice move on the far sideline, trying to clip back in. Ball still loose. And called back as no advantage materialized. It'll be a Dalton free kick, fairly dangerous location. Couple of Red Wolves over to talk about the kick. It's going to be Rasmus Anderson who scares everyone off. He'll be the one to place the ball. That usually means he'll be the one to take the kick. The 10 paces marked off. There comes the magic spray. Looping ball, looking far post, and what an important intervention by Kyle Oliveria. The Colorado State Pueblo student rising at the back post and nodding it away just before a waiting Red Wolf back post. It'll be the first corner of the game for the Dalton Red Wolves as Watson organizing the defense. A conga line forming right at the top of the box. Looks to be a good, some man marking, a little bit of zonal. It'll be Gavin Taylor, the short option at the angle. The ball played in, near post, just deflected out, corralled by Rodriguez, clipped back in, back post. It'll be ushered over the back line. It'll be a goal kick, Asheville City. Hey, 15 minutes gone. It's, I don't feel like either team's really grabbed this game and made it their own. But a couple potential dangerous moments both ways. Flipped over the top. He's done. All the way back for Barroetta. Dalton from the back. Ball working far sideline. Good turn on Blanton. Now it's about a one-on-one. The ball crossed, blocked by Oliveria. Loose top of the box. Here comes Asheville City away with it. And a vital intervention played forward. Touched down by Franca. Anderson plays it to the top. Franca, one step, the shot. Watson had to be aware. The follow-up back post blasted it off of the dorm, three stories up behind the pitch. A bounding ball that you've got to get on top of to have any chance of getting it on goal. That's not what happened. If it didn't bounce off the third floor of that building, it would be in the parking lot. Miller down the far sideline. The organization of Dalton Asheville City has found trouble playing through. As Dalton looking to press. Oliveria has space. Wide for Harriman. Puts it inside, gets it back. Slid wide. This much better from Asheville City. Blanton the shot. That's misses near post. It'll be out for a goal kick. That better interplay from Asheville City. Quickly moving it from far side to near side, and then two passes back to a Blanton cut on the far sideline. The shot certainly earned, just missing the far post. That certainly better moments from Asheville City. 18 minutes and change gone in the contest. Blanton wins the header. Here comes Asheville City looking to move quickly. Foul spotted as two and three defenders coming over to challenge. It'll be Asheville City right at the edge of what I would call a potentially dangerous location. I guess any location's dangerous if you're gutsy enough. No? Fair enough. Asheville City playing it short. Out wide. Miller. Harriman tries to find the overlapping run. Brings it back under control. Here's Ward trying to move the ball quickly to the far sideline. Blanton. Nice turn from Vatna. Vatna has space in front, cuts mid. And a fantastic tackle from Montoya, had to get it right. Ward keeps it, and the pressure on for Asheville City. Harriman, wide for Ward, who brings it under control. Excuse me, Miller, who brings it under control. The cross deflected towards the top of the box. Headed out of trouble. And Asheville City looking to keep the pressure on. Oliveria pushes wide. It's Asheville City reorganizing. Bending ball, trying to find Ward. Lebanon. Manaf for Miller. Trying to find where the space that Dalton is giving, clipped across the back to the run of Blanton, who gets onto the end of it. Slid out. It'll be an Asheville City throw far sideline. Vatna dances in. Blanton, his cross deflected. Asheville City throw. 28 minutes and change gone in the contest. This is a good spell of about a minute and a half, 2 minutes of a pressure and possession by Asheville City. Lavenant for Manaf. Miller towards the box. Nearly onto the head of a jumping Richards. And out for a goal kick. This Asheville City's got to be encouraged, even though the ball not finding the back of the net. Much better play by the Blues. The Red Wolves would look comfortable for the preceding six, perhaps 7 minutes. Looking to get back on the front foot. Deep distribution from Barota. Watson out to scoop. Ward on the far side. A as Dalton comes up with it. The pressure cracking Asheville as they attempt to play from the back. Oliveria getting a piece of it. That ball clipped forward. Stainrod can't hold it up. Pushed wide, dangerous ball, and at the last moment, Miller had to get it right and did. It'll be out for a Dalton throw near sideline. Anderson over to take the throw. Boy, Max Miller had to get his toe to it and only just got the toe. Tackled away. Harriman trying to build from the back. Slides one out. Oliveria, can he get there in time? No. Dalton throw near sideline. Asheville able to get the possession, but couldn't find that quick break forward. Tackled out. It'll be a Dalton throw near sideline. Anderson looking to settle things down. The tip of the spear now, Kieran Richards for Asheville City. Stainrod has taken up the center spot for Dalton Red Wolves. Stainrod, who scored a fantastic goal against Dalton, the game winner back in 2021. Clip forward, Miller will get onto it. Two on one, Miller, one touch, slides it through. Harriman makes it 1-0 Asheville City. Brilliant 1-2 touch, gets Max Miller into space. The unselfish pass back eliminates the goalkeeper. Harriman won't have an easier goal all season, but that's due to the fantastic build-up play between Max Miller and Kenzie Harriman. In the 25th minute, Harriman's with the goal. The assist to Kentucky's Max Miller. 1-0 Asheville City. Keep in mind that this is a Dalton Red Wolves team that is so well organized, no team this season has scored more than one goal against them.
Asheville City goal scored in the 25th minute by Quincy Harriman. Harriman's goal assisted by number 3, Max Miller. Miller to Harriman.
Miller had to
in
get
the 25th minute of play. Your score.
Barletta to commit.
Dalton
and when
Miller.
He did, slid one across to Harriman, who didn't stop. Back underway. Dalton looking to answer quickly. Looking down the far sideline. The diagonals have been where their head and their passes have been. Slid wide for Franca. Miller gets a foot on it. All the way back for Barletta. Barletta has to boot it deep down the center of the pitch. Preto nodding it forward. It's out for an Asheville City throw far sideline.
He's going, okay?
Scott Wells up, making defensive adjustments. There's your goal scorer, Harriman, looking for Miller again. Miller in stride, working on Anderson. And a fantastic tackle by Anderson. Manaf gets a fantastic slide tackle in, had to get it right. Manaf again winning the tackle. This has been good back and forth. That booted deep for Watson. Watson will settle things. Ward, far sideline. Harriman's wearing the captain's armband tonight for Asheville City. Oliveria back to Harriman, who's looking to slide one in as Blanton trying to push that back line. Vatna trying to settle on it. Vatna had it, lost it. It'll be Perry the first to it. clipped away. It's Asheville City throw far sideline. Watson back. Five changes for Asheville City coming into this match. Certainly want to put a quality team out knowing how sound positionally this Dalton Red Wolves team is, but you do have to keep an eye out because next week you've got another 1v2 as Asheville City traveling down to the Bantams of SC United on Tuesday. Tonight, SC United taking on the Southern Soccer Academy Kings in a battle of second and third. Both of those teams are going to really want 3 points to solidify their hold on second. But Asheville City, I'm sure, wouldn't mind splitting the points because that's really 2 points gained for them. Chested down. Ehrman flipping it forward. From the back, Gavin Taylor. Miller with a lot of space in front, has runners. Ehrman out to his right. Richards to his left. Slides it far right, one touch, look up. Vatna brings it back under control. The shot deflected. It'll be out for an Asheville City corner there, first of the game.
City, you have a corner kick.
And to the 30th minute, Asheville City wins their first corner of the game. It's been a physical but clean game thus far. Knock on wood. Thank you. Clipped near post, doesn't beat the first man. Vatna. A foul spotted, it'll be a free kick. Now they're gonna say it hit the referee and it'll be Dalton's ball on a dropped ball. Bit unlucky for Asheville City as Vatna looked to pressure to perhaps win that ball back. It'll be Barroetta. 15 minutes left plus any stoppage time. Preto escorting that out into touch. It'll be a Red Wolves throw far sideline. Back again to the back line. Dalton looking to build. When they've been at their most dangerous, I mean, the corner certainly looked dangerous, but playing the diagonals, that ball not very clean. Clipped forward. Manaf, here's Ehrman. Enough, trying to turn. It'll be played for Ward. Ward. Olivaria on the turn. Dancing. Played forward. Nice. Gather by Richards. The shot from distance always rising. But that nifty little bit of footwork found himself half a yard of space.
And broker and director of operations for our women's
I don't
team.
Hate him taking that chance.
You can learn more.
Shot in Kieran Richards' bag. Seen it at East Tennessee State. We mentioned a little bit about Barroetta and what a good job he's done for Dalton State this past season. National Player of the Week for October 4th, 2022. A shutout against the number one team in the country will earn you National Player of the Week. Pushed wide. Miller has it taken away. Stainrod, almost lost out. Asheville City throw near sideline. Nearly pulled back by Stainrod. Good control as Levenant pushing it wide for Blanton. Blanton and Miller really pushing the bounds of the wingbacks. Played out, Asheville City throw, far sideline. Five substitutes on the Red Wolves bench tonight. It's Nawadiwa, Saika, Mendiola, Joseph Dodson, and Winya. Miller trying to get in on it. It's ushered over the end line for a goal kick. Eleven and a half minutes left. Barroetta with the distribution. Plus whatever stoppage time is assessed. Shouldn't be a ton, not a lot of injuries, no cards. One goal. A couple minutes, one, maybe two. Be my guess. Ball played, far sideline. Pranto lets it bounce. Ward. Richards goes up for it. Looped in behind. It's going to be Miller the first to it. Miller, one touch. Keeps his feet. The shot just over the bar. A lot of players might go down. He caught just a touch of contact.
Agent Kyle Stockton of the PMC Insurance Agency.
And that's one thing that I really like about Max Miller in that position is he kept his footing, although the shot just rising above. A fantastic opportunity brought on by the pressure from Asheville City. 10 minutes of regular time left in the first half. Franto nodding it up. Asheville City throw far sideline. Last touched by Perry. Manaf back for Miller. Herman the option out wide. Good tackle by Anderson. Or check that. I think that might have been Gavin Taylor. Got his body across Richards, but it was a fair challenge. He was the one who was in position to play the ball. Anderson asking for it on the near sideline, really pushing that back line. Blasted near sideline. That's going to be, it's going to outpace everybody except for Will Watson, who's back. Leaves it for Preto. Ward. Levenant plays it back for Preto. Here's Ward. Oliveria leaves it for Preto. Manoff in some space. Clip through the middle. Levenant couldn't push it forward. It's taken off of his shoelaces, and here comes Dalton from the back. The foot race is on. Anderson showing his strength, and it's going to be a goal kick. Boy, that was a fantastic battle between Manoff and Anderson charging down the near sideline. Anderson the first to the ball, but couldn't control it. Lost it over the end line. Thanks in large part to the pressure Abdul Manaf, Jacksonville University's own, was giving him down the near sideline. Here's Manoff. Tackled away. It'll be Asheville City throw near sideline. Vincent Montoya over to make the challenge. That was a dangerous shot off the boot of Miller against his own goal. Well, Watson not called into service. It'll be a corner kick. Anderson over to take it. Keep an eye certainly on Joshua Ramos, the wing back. Anderson places the ball. The near option, Gavin Taylor, just from the top of the box, right at the corner. Anderson, an outswinging left-footed cross on the, corner on the way. Looks near post. Lifted up. Scampering over is Rodriguez, trying to send it back in, back post. Held in, Anderson, clues it up to the six, knotted on, past Watson. And Dalton, for the first time, has two teams score in the same match. And that one, a perfect cross from Anderson. Not enough pressure on him as he clips it to the six. And Will Watson can't come over. Asheville City player down in distress. And excuse me, that's going to be slow to his feet, Anderson. Your assist getter. Little limp on the left leg. One Dalton, Asheville City.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dalton Red Wolves goal scored by number 30, Jack Stainrod.
Stainrod is now evened up his account between Asheville City and Dalton.
In the 39th minute, your score now, Asheville City 1, Dalton 1.
Stainrod should feel like he's evened up the account. Miller. Is Asheville City looking to answer back quickly? Anderson welcomed back onto the pitch. Oliveria. Ward. Across the back line. Here's Manaf. Miller. Able to keep possession. Manaf. Here's Preto. Ward moving wide. His space taken away. Oliveria trying to find Huerman, Asheville's goal scorer. Oliveria back for Harriman. Clips forward for Oliveria, who has it in some space. His path forward taken away. Good hesitation. Booted deep down the pitch. Preto nodding it out. What he thinks might be a safe spot. Battle for the ball. Nice turn by the Red Wolves. Fouled from behind. It'll be a Dalton free kick. Asheville City has shown glimpses of brilliance, especially moving forward, but they've looked perhaps in danger, specifically on set pieces. And here's another one for the Red Wolves. Anderson swings another one in, back post. Manoff does enough to knot it down. Searching ball. Still dangerous. Stainrod trying to seize onto the end of it. It is blasted away. Still Dalton looking to turn it back into a dangerous area. As Dalton reorganizes, Asheville City, as Harriman tries to get it away. Blanton able to get it away. Held up by Vatna. Manaf. Manaf has some space. Wide for Miller. Into the final, two minutes of regular time in the half, plus whatever stoppage time the officials deem. Vatna, good turn. Oliveria. Harriman, good touch. Out for Miller. Help arriving into the box. Richards. That was the target. Blasted away. Oliveria. Levenant. There's Miller again. Harriman's shot rising out for a goal kick. One all, Asheville City and Dalton Red Wolves into the final 60 seconds of regular time in the half. Hearing word of that, it'll be about a minute of added time. Fredo nodding it forward. Manoff gets in a good tackle. Harriman trying to settle, does so well. Harriman spinning away. Richards clipping it too high for Miller running down the near sideline. It'll be out for a Dalton throw. Clipped up, Prado nodding it forward. Vatna tries to slide it away, can't do it. Twisting, turning, options pushed wide for Anderson. Good run by Ramos. Ramos, the cross deflected as Prado unable to save it in. It'll be a corner for the Red Wolves into stoppage time. Anderson over, it'll be an outswinging left-footed corner. Near post. And that was a terrible collision. Both players going for the ball, but a foul spotted. It'll be an Asheville City free kick deep into the 1 minute of stoppage time, and that blast of the whistle tells us we're off to the locker rooms.
The score after 45 minutes, Asheville City 1.
16th Dalton minute. Kinsey Harriman goal made it 1-0. And a 39th minute Jack Stainrod header made it 1-1. As we go to the halftime break, all and tied at one. It's all to play for. 45 minutes of the second half coming up after this halftime break. You're watching Asheville City and Dalton Red Wolves. to the strains of Seth Rollins' Visionary. We're back live from Asheville, North Carolina. Getting you ready for the second half. Dalton Red Wolves taking on Asheville City Soccer Club. Tied 1-1 after the opening 45 minutes. 45 left in the books. Asheville City and their alternate kits, the Blue Firefly kits. The Blue Firefly, a rare deviation of the Firefly that's found only a couple places in the world. And all of those couple places are around Asheville, North Carolina. The Blue Firefly, right around this time of year, instead of the yellow bioluminescent glow that the normal firefly will emit, a blue firefly will emit a blue that's very, very similar to the one you see on the bottom of the Asheville City kits. Another differentiator between a normal firefly and the blue firefly is a blue firefly can leave the illumination for up to a minute. Asheville City. No changes. Dalton Red Wolves, no changes into the second 45.
All right, come back, come back!
Curling ball looking over the top. Richards giving a run. It's better safe than sorry for the Red Wolves, who play it out over the sideline. Asheville City and Max Miller to get things started. Richards brings it under control. Oliveria gets just enough of it to keep possession. Brings in Malcolm Ward. Manoff down the far sideline. Max Miller, who's been effervescent throughout the first 45. Josiah Blanton pushing the bounds here on the right side of the Dalton Red Wolves defense. Ward brings in Blanton. Blanton pushes it deep. Vatna cross and would have been right in the path of Richards. But a flag up on the far sideline as Vatna spotted a step early. It'll be a Red Wolves free kick to get things back underway. Barretta. Reno up, gets a piece of it. Miller back, firm enough. Stolen away by the Red Wolves. Bit of a heavy touch, Vatna gets a piece of it. Blanton tries to play it back inside, stolen away Red Wolves. Ward boots it up the sideline. Vatna giving chase. All the way back for Barretta. Blasted up. Foul spotted. It'll be whistled on the Red Wolves. It looks like Mason Dalton spotted for the contact. Dalton and Levinant going up together. Miller gets it wide, has options in the box. The cross over Bake, trying to find Josiah Blanton back post. He'll go out for a Dalton Red Wolves throw near sideline. Just too much on it for Miller. Good idea. It'll be a Red Wolves throw, ushered out by Ward. Ramos. Blanton able to get a foot on it. Oliveria trying to slide it to Miller. Miller has a long run, but is able to get onto the end of it. Harriman. Richards turns it back centrally. The shot low, deflected. Oliveria unable to slide it away. 3-on-2. The shot from distance, curling wide, perhaps a bit high. Ward flipping one up, trying to find the run of Blanton. It's a dangerous ball. Blanton is able to get onto the end of it. Blanton settles, leaves it. Vatna into the box. Vatna crosses, one touch. Richards, perhaps a touch too much. The blast, always rising. Hands to the head for Harriman. It's the second time he's had a good look from the edge of the box.
Specialists helping Asheville City players and local youth soccer community.
Second time it's drifted just wide, but his
visit the HF Center
opening goal.
Training facility on Fairview Road near JBL.
Absolutely perfect 1-2 play with Max Miller. Jack Steinrod tying things up after a brilliant curling ball right to the sixth. And Steinrod nodding it, the only place it could go. Preto pushing it wide. Harriman trying to hold on to it, does so. Harriman, the cross, low, trying to find Vatna, deflected and collected by Barroetta. Good idea. As Vatna's back post run looked to be dangerous. A little over 6 minutes gone in the second half. Barrowett has had it for about 25 seconds now. Clipped wide. Here's Windham. It's Manoff shouldering away, able to escort it out for a goal kick. Good strength shown by Abdul Manoff. Here's Preto. Levinon for Blanton. Tackled away, it'll be out for a Dalton throw near sideline. Richards tries to leave it off for Blanton. Taken away by Montoya. Steinrod has it. Invites Franca forward. Franca continuing his run forward. Here's Perry. Perry's shot, dangerous. Watson scoops it cleanly. A knuckling effort, far post, and Watson was able to see the entire way. Ward for Blanton. Manoff has space in front. Manoff taking up that space. Harriman. Spins for space, has some down the far sideline. Richards invites Ward forward. Blanton in front of him. Blanton has it. Slid down, it'll be out for a goal kick. Fantastic challenge as Joshua Ramos comes over, slides it away, plays it off of Blanton. Nearly 10 minutes gone in the second half. We haven't really seen, other than the Harriman shot from distance, anything of substance from either team, really. Evident. Lift on, Harriman able to collect it, pushes it wide for Manaf. That's a long run for Manaf, who comes on to the end of it. Oliveria. Looking for Blanton. That'll be out for an Asheville City throw near sideline. Substitutions. Looked like Frank Gomez warming up. Ward sprays it wide. Harriman brings it back centrally. Slide pass. Tries to find Blanton. Good tackle. Ooh. As Blanton able to get in front, get contact on the ball. But Ramos hitting the ground gets called. Gets the call, and the foul on Blanton gives the free kick to the Red Wolves. Lift into space. Vatna nearly able to get onto the end of it. Prado has been really calm on those lobbed balls towards the back line. Here's Ward. Levenant. Here's Prado. Showing patience on the ball. Wide for Ward. Looks front and Richards gets it in behind. Flag stays down. Blanton, one-on-one, the nutmeg, and it's 2-1 Asheville City. Josiah Blanton. One-on-one with Barrota. And it's a touch of brilliance as three substitutions now for the Blues. Juan Ballas, Liam Henley, and Matty Cornish over to check in for Asheville City. Boy, what a ball forward, and Josiah Blanton doing a fantastic job just to check his run to make sure he stays onside. Just playing right on that last defender's shoulder. And it's a thing of beauty.
Asheville City goal.
It'll be a quadruple substitution.
Blanton's goal comes in the 57th minute of play. Your score now, Asheville City 2.
And that is Josiah Blanton's last action of the game, as his 57th minute goal sees him substituted out along with Lavenant, Richards, Blanton, and Scott Vatna. Brings in Gomez, Matty Cornish, Juan Ballas, and Liam Henley. So four substitutions for Asheville City. Good dancing from Henley. Advantage played. Moving quickly in transition. Still the ball, the cross. Watson gave out.
In the 58th minute, now in the match for Asheville.
And it'll be
Liam Henley. Number 5, Frank Gomez.
An Asheville City goal kick.
Juan Ballas.
Perry
and number
took
7,
a bit
Matty
of a challenge.
Cornish. Gomez, Cornish, Ballas, and Henley.
Here's Asheville City, Gamma's near sideline. Into the run of Ballas. Tackled away. Prado still anchoring this back line. Here's Gamma's. Cornish for Prado. Prado so calm on the ball. Manaf Turn from Oliveria. Perriman. Asheville City, as you'll see, has had a bit of a switch of wingbacks. You're going to see Malcolm Ward and Max Miller have flip-flopped sides, at least temporarily. Now you see Kinsey Harriman over in the wide slot, and he's called into action. That off of the shoelaces forward. It'll be Dalton throw on the near sideline. Tried to find the run of Max Miller forward. Harriman settles it. Oliveria calm, plays it back wide. Here's Miller. Miller threw a lot of traffic, somehow spins away with the ball. And behind the play, yet again, it was Perry who's hit the ground. Nice tackle far sideline. Asheville City still with the possession. Oliveria. Enough. All the way back for Preto. Ehrman. Preto moving forward, clips it forward. Harriman's run. And it's picked off of Harriman's toes by Guilherme Franca. It'll be a corner for Asheville City. Asheville City leading 2-1. Other than the 6-0 game against North Alabama, this is the second game that Dalton Red Wolves have had that's not 1-0.
A friend of soccer in Western North Carolina for more than 3 decades. That's Carolina Color Tones.
In swinging right-footed corner on the way. Looking back post. Everybody up in the... Crossbar still shaking as Cornish tracks it down. Eyes up. Slides it across for Ward. My goodness, Asheville nearly going up 2 goals. Oliveria for Harriman. Tries to slide one to the top of the box. Here comes Dalton looking to move in transition. Clips one forward. Be a sprinting Miller. All the way for Watson. Oliveria clips it back for Gamiz. Cornish is now occupying that wide spot. Josiah Blanton was occupying as Oliveria looking up, looking for options. Harriman drops it off for Henley. Gamiz. Cornish. Gets pulled back twice. Henley able to scoop up the pass. Manaf wide. Ward in possession. Ehrman plays it back for Preto. Here's far sideline Miller. Plays back for Cornish. The overlap just too far ahead of Miller. Well, that was a very similar to the 1-2 into space for Miller earlier. This time just too far ahead. Striding forward, pushed wide. A long, long run, but it's made by Anderson. Manaf gets to the ball, and he's down in pain. After the contact, and Manaf down in pain. And they're asking for assistance, and here come the trainers.
Fans Mission Health, a proud supporter of Asheville City Soccer and their fans. If you're a recreational player, one of the athletes competing today, Mission's team of athletic trainers and sports medicine physicians.
They'll use this injury.
You healthy and active.
As a de facto water break, touch base with maybe tactically get a couple of words. It is a humid night in Asheville. The temperature is not much out of the high 60s, low 70s, somewhere in there. But it's a humid night. It smells like rain, even though there's not a cloud in the sky.
You can sample their ciders at one of two Asheville tap rooms. For more information, visit noblecider.com.
Not your typical sweaty June evening in Asheville.
Asheville City Soccer.
I'm going to pull up the exact temperature. It's balmy, 68 degrees, but the humidity is pretty solid, to be honest with you. Marietta's distribution deep down the center of the pitch. Gatma is rising to it. Cornish chests it to Henley. Manaf able to stay on. Oh, nice bit from Harriman. Wide. The cross. Dangerous. Oh, had to get it right. And Barrowetta seizing onto it. And here come Dalton moving the other way. Pushed wide. A bit frantic over the last few seconds from Dalton. Here's Rodriguez, looping one forward. One touch, but Oliveria able to seize onto it. Here's Henley through the middle. Slides one, trying to find Cornish. The volley attempt by Wehrman, unsuccessful. With time, Perry pushes it wide. 1-2 with Ramos, gets it back. No substitutions yet from Dalton. The 66 minutes gone. Nice strength shown by Gammas. Leaves it off. And here comes Dalton the other way. Stainrod turning, pushing it into space. Here's Ramos. Ramos, good step over, has some space, wants to seize onto it. Can't find a ball. Flag stays down. The cross deflected. And it's out. It'll be a corner kick. Corner kick for Dalton. It was the aftermath of a corner where the Red Wolves scored their first goal. And Anderson's been fantastic on the deliveries all day. He's so good with the deliveries, I think he part-times with DoorDash. You don't have to make eye contact. That one blasted away all the way to Barrowetta. Trying to change the point of attack, knotted down. Cornish gives chase. It's blasted away. It'll be an Asheville City throw near sideline. Settled well. Deflected. Manaf comes over, gets a piece of it, deflected out. Nope, it'll be last touched by Manaf. Asheville City doing some last-ditch defending. It'll be a throw for Joshua Ramos and the Dalton Red Wolves. Dalton have been advancing slightly farther up the field, but a slip sees Asheville City and Harriman charging forward. Harriman spotted on the wrap. And the whistle, and that'll be a yellow card. And the officials given a yellow card to Asheville City head coach Scott Wells. Ball batted up, still loose. the bicycle. That one falls harmlessly over the end line. It'll be a goal kick for Asheville City.
Fans, come watch and celebrate your love of soccer at Old London Road. Not just a dedicated soccer pub. There's a full-time food truck, amazing fish and chips, wings and burgers, and outdoor soccer tennis. Old London Road, it's where we watch.
Into the 70th minute. Here's Asheville City. Gamez from the back. Slides it in for Harriman. Miller. Lost out. And Dalton's first substitution near to happening. The ball flung deep. Enough settling it. Far sideline. Wadiwa set to come on. Here's Rehrman. Left for Ward, pushed very wide. Cornish moving forward, still on the ball. Cornish, the clipped ball, top of the box, Herman's shot deflected. It'll be out for an Asheville City throw. That'll bring in Kuda and Wadiwa.
Substitution coming.
Second substitution
Dalton
in the offing as well for Dalton. Wadiwa is taking the place of.
Entering the match will be number two, Kuda Niwatiwa. Kuda Niwatiwa, number two, replacing number 35, Erasmus Anderson.
In, taking the place of Anderson. Anderson's had a fantastic night in his 70 minutes of game action. He's looked dangerous as Rasmus Anderson and his one assist out. Jamie Mendiola in the offing as well. Next dead ball, Asheville City with the throw. Unable to control, it'll be out for a Dalton throw near sideline. And another stoppage of play.
Substitution for Dalton. Number seven, Mendiola. Jaime Mendiola replaces number 99, Zachary Perry.
That's taking the place of Zachary Perry is Jamie Mendiola.
Perry in the 72nd minute.
Stainrod had it, lost it. Good bit of running by Oliveria. And Alec McKinley for Asheville City will be the next to check in along with Clay O'Bara as he's receiving his final charges from the skipper. Oliveria, who's covered approximately 33 yards, and Abdul Manaf due to come off at the next stoppage. Here's Gamez pushed forward. Vital intervention by the Red Wolves. Now trying to move it through the center of the park. Ward giving chase. Foul spotted as Ward making contact from behind. And here come the substitutions. Abdul Manaf off.
He's in the 73rd minute. Substitutions for Asheville.
And that's going to bring on Clay O'Bara.
32, Alec McKinley.
Alec McKinley on as well and taking the place of Oliveria. Although I think we'll probably see McKinley on the back line and probably see O'Bara more in the central midfield area.
And
a fantastic shift by both Oliveria and Abdul Manaf has had a fantastic night on the right side of that Asheville City back three. Ball lifted, headed up into the center of the pitch. A sky header by McKinley. Here comes Dalton on the ball. Good one-touch passing, trying to find a bit of space, and they're going to play it all the way back through Taylor. Taylor, a tough ball for Barroetta to handle. Good one-touch. Here is Nwadiwa playing back for Barroetta. Niwatiwa, that ball looking for him and finds him. Slips a bit on the turf and the contact from the back draws the whistle as Max Miller able to draw the foul. It'll be an Asheville City free kick. Into the final 15 minutes of regular time, you saw a little bit of an injury. You saw a goal. You saw several substitutions. Nodded back into the center. He, Henley, good touch. Herman pushes it wide. Into the box, the shot deflected. It'll be out for an Asheville City corner.
Asheville City will have a corner kick.
Again, you have to win this match if you're Asheville City. You're just now rising on the national rankings. You want to be in the conversation for hosting playoffs, but you also have a match Tuesday against the Bantams of SC United. They're currently in second place. The ball in doesn't beat the first defender. It'll be out for an Asheville City throw. And it's a fine line that the Asheville City coaching staff is having to walk in preparedness for Tuesday's match and ensuring that tonight's match is a victory. And for Dalton, you need all the points you can get wherever you can get them. We've got Jack Stainrod in, and he's shown his attacking mettle both in Asheville City and now for Dalton. Gamiz. Max Miller, here's Harriman. Harriman rolls fantastic. Good ball control from Harriman. Borderline magician on the ball. Wow for Harriman. Good from Gamiz, pushing forward, finds Miller. Miller eyes up, the cross to the six. Nearly finding Obara, who laid out for it. Obara and Barroetta somehow threads the needle between the two, and it goes out across the far sideline untouched. Asheville with possession. Gamiz. Preto. Ward. That's knocked out. It'll be an Asheville City throw. Check that. It'll be a Red Wolves throw. Knotted up. This is dangerous. And Max Miller saving a calamitous situation by getting a foot in. Oh, what a touch. Asheville City settles it down, spins away. Into the run of McKinley. McKinley pushes wide. To the top of the box. The dummy run, the shot from distance. Oh, it's just perfection! Liam Henley, a wildie to make it 3-1 Asheville City. What a shot, Liam Henley. My goodness. John Keats once said, "A thing of beauty is a joy forever." That goal, may it be a joy for specifically to the Asheville City fans, but my goodness, it was a thing of beauty. 3-1 Asheville City with 11 minutes left in regular time.
By number 26, Liam Henley.
My goodness, I'm still replaying that in my head. You're lucky you get to watch the replay at home. Absolutely brilliant bit of skill all the way back for Will Watson. My goodness, what a goal by Henley. Nearly 80 minutes gone in this contest. The blue smoke now enveloping the far sideline. That ball clipped over the top. It's a foot race. Controlled Asheville City into a dangerous spot. Asking questions as Ballas was the target. Ball held in by Dalton, far sideline. Strong run by Ramos. Long run for Nwatiwa. Good diagonals from Dalton. Asheville City's final sub. The shot distance. Watson watches it cruise over. Olivar Correa due to come in. Olivier Correa.
Substitution for Asheville City. End of the match, number 21, Olivier Correa.
As Correa comes on, that'll do it for Kinsey Herman. The goal getter for Asheville City's first in Chapel Hill zone.
82nd minute.
Herman off in the 82nd minute. That'll bring Correa on. Asheville has used all of its bench. Good 1-2, that'll trickle over the sideline. Asheville City throw. Here's Miller to throw. Cornish finding space, and McKinley eyes up as it slid away. It'll be an Asheville City throw, far sideline. Good tackle by Mendiola. Got the ball before taking the player. Asheville's throw-in must happen a little bit closer to their own goal as it's pushed forward. Slip, and here comes Ramos down the far sideline. Ramos has up ahead of steam, and he's taken down unceremoniously by Malcolm Ward. And that'll be the first yellow card of the game issued to Malcolm Ward in the 83rd minute. Ward, who picked up the captain's armband as Herman's replaced. It'll be a free kick right at the edge of a dangerous area. I'll say that given the number of substitutions, we'll call it a dangerous area.
Asheville City, number 2, Malcolm Ward issued a caution in the 83rd minute. Ward issued the caution in the 83rd minute.
The congregation at the top of the box, one touch on. Taylor loops it in from a weird angle. Watson comes out, beats everyone to it. Niwatiwa was the target.
Look at it!
Coach Wells asking for pressure as it'll be three substitutes. The rest of the bench emptying out for Dalton into the 85th minute. Here's Ramos on the far sideline. Slips down, able to maintain possession of the ball. That's over on the end line. Still in, Ward scoots it back. It'll be Saika, Dotson, and Wenya coming in. Batted up. Boy, what a nice touch from Cornish. Back heels it right into the path. Here comes Asheville City, curling ball, top of the box. One touch. Can't get it out from under his feet. As Cleo Barra had eyes on goal. Asheville City still in possession. 85 minutes gone, 5 minutes of regular time. Gamez slid out. It'll be an Asheville City throw near sideline, and here come the substitutions. Mizuka Saika.
Substitutions coming for Dalton.
Saika coming on.
Entering the match, number four, Mizuki Saika. Number 37,
Mizuki Saika, as Ian Windham is out. Mason Dalton is out along with Vincent Montoya. Saika, Dotson, and Winya into the matchup for the Dalton Red Wolves. It'll be Asheville City throw. Ballas thought he had clipped it over to himself, unable to really get a piece of it. Tackled in brilliantly well by McKinley. Nice step over and a fantastic pass into space. Ballas. Over a couple of outstretched legs, tries to push it wide, gets hung up. His back leg slid out. Back is Miller, who collects it. Good patience on the ball as Jersey yanked from behind, spotted by the official. It'll be an Asheville City free kick. Here's Asheville City. Played back, Gamez, into the 88th minute. Gamez using his speed to get free. Wide for Ward. Ward has some space, we'll take that space. Flipping over the top, looking for Miller. Knotted away. It'll be an Asheville City throw near sideline into the 88th, now 89th minute. Gamez slips to the ground. Oh, nice move, step over from Ramos. Ramos curling to the top of the box. Loose touch by Steinrod. Dalton trying to find the space to shoot. Into the box, the shot. Finding the back of the net and cuts the deficit to one. In the 89th minute. Dalton in the 89th minute makes it a one goal game. Asheville City the first time they've given up two goals in one game. That ball lost by Ballas out of bounds. It'll be a Dalton throw into the 90th minute. The goal scorer, fresh off the bench, Jaime Mendiola. Here's Cornish, able to maintain possession. Twisting and turning across back to the back line. And here's Preto. All the way back for Watson. Watson deep down the center of the pitch. That'll be Asheville City throw. The fourth official indicating there will be 4 minutes of added time.
The official indicating there'll be a minimum of four added minutes in the second half. Four.
As Cornish, or excuse me, that was Correa who was drawing the
Dalton
foul.
Goal.
Dangerous spot for the free kick.
Mendiola. Mendiola,
4 minutes of added time. Can Dalton find a third?
Dalton 2, Asheville City 3.
A minimum of 4 minutes of added time to be played will feel like forever for Asheville City. You take a, if you're Matty Cornish, you really, you have space to get this up and down. This is a really dangerous spot. Cornish on the run-up, takes a crack off the crossbar, or off the post, a shot. Oh, it's spectacular! And that should do it, Clay O'Bara. On the rebound from the post, O'Bara hits a rising shot that finds the back of the net, and Asheville City leads 4-2. You've seen some spectacular goals today for both teams. The Stainrod header. As Clay O'Bara. Boy, I was going to say, after giving him so much credit, I really hope it's Clay O'Bara. And it was, thank goodness. I'm old and my eyes don't work like they used to, but it sure looked like a 17 to me.
Scored by number 17, Clay O'Bara.
Preto nodding it forward as he's done all day.
O'Bara's goal scored in.
And now Asheville City looking on the quick counter, trying to slide in.
Leads 4-2.
Correa, that ball's still loose. The unsecure hand of Barroetta, something he hasn't been doing all day. And it'll be Matty Cornish over to take the corner for Asheville City. Asheville City certainly in no hurry, up two goals and into the third minute of stoppage time. It'll be a short. Cornish looping one. Slid away. Ward will be giving chase. And he'll escort it out of bounds. The center official saying, let's make sure we get the ball back in play without being unreasonable. Asheville City trying not to get any cards. Obliges down the sideline. Asheville City with runners in the box, but you'd rather have the time off the clock instead of the cross right there. Asheville City back down towards the corner flag. Clipped up and able to maintain possession. This is a good bit from Asheville City. Curling ball into the back. O'Bara able to save it in. My goodness, O'Bara's been fantastic and he's brought down. Into the final minute of extra time.
Not even four yet. Yeah, yeah, we're almost four. We got it, we got you. We're on it.
And with the blast of the whistle, that'll do it.
Ladies
Asheville
and gentlemen,
Asheville City
through Dalton
three goal second half performance makes it a 4-2 victory over the Red Wolves of Dalton, Georgia. Dalton will fall to 3-5 on the season. Asheville City 6-0-1, now on 19 points in seven games. Still a game in hand on about half of the conference, as they have a date with the SC United Bantams in Columbia, South Carolina on Tuesday. Three straight on the bounce for Asheville City.
Asheville City remains atop the South Central Division.
Here goal scorer Clay O'Bara
to 2 victory.
Adding that extra goal. Mendiola made it interesting with his 84th minute goal to make it a 1-goal game.
And now we'll play Ryan Kelly's
the goals
favorite song
from Kinsey Harriman to kick things off, answered immediately by Jack Stainrod. Leo Barra, a fantastic goal. Malcolm Ward, a fantastic game. Max Miller, great assist, brilliant in the attack. Liam Henley was maybe, arguably, a goal of the week contender. Just ripped one from a couple of yards outside the box. Comprehensive team victory for Asheville City tonight. For Asheville City, a slight dip away before coming back. Their next matchup at home on July 8th. For Dalton, it's a trip back down to Georgia. This very well-organized and extremely capable team. As Jack Stainrod having a momentary conversation with Isaiah Vignali. They were teammates 2 years ago on Asheville City. That'll do it for us. Let you take in the rest of the celebrations. To the strains of Come On Eileen. For our entire broadcast crew, I'm Matt Stradley saying so long. Your final score, Asheville City Soccer Club 4, the Dalton Red Wolves Soccer Club 2.